Jack Kaguge Dhai. I'm a practitioner of African traditional medicine for over 50 years now. And I have also been participating in the debate on COVID-19, including treating people and all that. It has significantly affected me. One way in that I got it, the year that was 2019. COVID-19 did not come in Kenya in the year 2020. It came earlier than that. And I had it when I treated a patient who had a contact with a Chinese who had come over. It looks a very funny condition. I treated the patient. He came for medicine to my place twice. I think I got it. My wife got it. And I treated them. It has affected me also in that it has affected people that I work with. It has affected my children on several occasions and had to treat them. And it has, of course, affected the economy, and national economy affects everybody. So it has affected very many. Well, I go by what they are telling us, that is Delta, it's originated from India. We have had others from elsewhere. And I see like it's much more aggressive, much more serious. The patients I've treated are taking much longer. They are needing stronger medicine than the earlier, those who got the earlier variant. So my understanding is it's spreading fast, it's very aggressive, and it is much more serious. And it's very devastating to people who have a dying condition and people who are old like me. I think the political gatherings are spreading quite a lot behind the scene because the politicians are on their campaign mood everywhere. And even those who are not going public, I think they are convening people in private places, in funny places, and they are doing that carelessly, that we're spreading a lot of the disease when they shouldn't be doing that. On the other hand, churches, there are too many. Those fanatic religious groups that thrive on the money that the worshippers bring in, they are really dying to have people convene for whatever they are calling prayers. And COVID-19 doesn't know prayers. Any gathering that brings people closer makes them vulnerable to contracting the disease. So my view is we are just at the verge of having even areas of worship banned until this wave goes away. When it comes to which other?
Social
gathering. There are many. The weddings, the dowry ceremonies, places, venues, some sporting events that are being done, including the rally at Naivasha, which became very popular. It may have spread a lot, and a lot of those should be avoided. Otherwise, we are gravitating a situation that is very dangerous to our life, and the more we gather people together, the longer it takes. I have been traveling across the country, and you only see where there are police or where there are government people around. When you go to rural settings, along roadsides, many places they are not. And that means we are in real big danger of spreading the disease and losing many more people than we would have lost if we had hired strictly to the Ministry of Health rules and guidelines.